Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, wherever you are, whenever you are. Thank you for watching this video and all my videos. Today we're going to be talking about, wow, Bitcoin's last few days have been super bearish, even today. Unbelievable. We're going to be doing a little discussion about that, the comparison that bearishness with the market fundamentals. Because when I show you the fundamentals, you're not going to reconcile what's going on in the price. It doesn't make much sense, and we're going to talk about that in a little bit. Also, we're going to be doing some questions and answering period, basically questions from my Telegram group subscribers. So if you want to be a Telegram group subscriber, check in the link in the description below. And yeah, you could just subscribe to Pandora's Wallet, and you could enter and become part of the group. Okay, with that said, let's head over to technical analysis. As you can see, I have this rising wedge pattern here, that we're at the bottom of half of it and we're breaking through. We can't bring this line down any further. This line is we have like stretched it to the limit. It's bringing us down, just does not have any touch points. So this is it. This is it here. So Bitcoin looks like it's hanging on by a thread. Can I stay up? And honestly, this does not look good. This does not bode well, because what we have here, if we really look at this objectively, right, we have like the slope of hope here. If we ignore this pop-up here, it's the slope of hope. We have to break higher, break back into the th above the 13 EMA, or else forget it. This thing's gonna it could possibly ride this thing up slowly, but then break. I mean, it's gonna be brutal. Another thing it could do is break down and then test it the other side of the line. There's gonna be this looks really nasty one way or another. And it's going to be really hard to trade. If you want to hang on to a long, right, that we did, we had like a, I had a long here. Let's head over to this side here. It was a Hail Mary long, and obviously we had to raise it because of this movement here, to up here. But I didn't bother, and I kept my entry. And notice how we retested my entry. And I'm getting a little concerned, because usually when the Hail Mary trades get retested, it doesn't work out very well. So yeah, I don't have much hope for this, right? This trade, and I don't have much hope for Bitcoin itself, because we broke above the 13 EMA. I was bullish when this thing happened. We got in. The reason why I was bullish, because if we take a look at, so in this chart, you can see that when we rose up to the third to into this point of control, basically. This is called the point of control for the volume in the VPVR, or the volume indicators. Basically, this thing basically said that we had a probability, 80% probability that we'd come back and test the 10,000 area. We didn't. We decided to choose the 20% level and go down. And so, yeah, that's why I was bullish when we were up in this level here, at $9,800 level. So that's clearly what should have transpired, but did not. With that said, we have to break this level again. We have to break this level, or else we're done for. And this is a very far away point. Bitcoin could always, do the what you call day. This is Bitcoin kind of thing, and kick us up higher. But this is not looking good. If we compare it on Ethereum has the same problem. We can't move this trend line anymore. We've already broke down twice through this trend line, and today, if we don't close up above this trend line, I can't say anything positive about Ethereum anymore. I think Ethereum's gonna roll over and die, and it's sad, right? I mean, we look at the let's just take a look at the CME, and to give us some more information. And it's just the same thing, right? We see M's within M's that are being drawn out, and I don't see any W's coming anywhere. So like I see an M right here, right? And yeah, I mean, it's clear where the breaking points are, right? And you can see I've already drawn out the breaking points. That's it. The TA doesn't give us any kind of hope at all for Bitcoin. And I'm like, I'm shocked. I'm shocked. And you want to know why I'm shocked? Well, it's because like we have like a lot of different news articles. For example, PayPal may start selling cryptocurrencies directly, which would change everything. Duh. Right? We have like Grayscale buys 3 times the amount of new Bitcoin and Ethereum. That's insane. That's insane. Right? Sorry, Ethereum's at a 350% premium. What the hell? What the hell? Oh my gosh. That's just crazy. We have 7-Eleven, CVS and Rite Aid selling Bitcoins, right? We have the German stock exchange, right? Willing to list Bitcoin, ETP, and you could buy Bitcoin with a click. We have like you're able to pay for your passport in Venezuela with Bitcoins. JP Morgan is no longer going to stop you from buying Bitcoins from Coinbase and all the rest of the exchanges out there, because they're actually going to allow them to do banking with them. So obviously they're gonna allow people who want to buy from their Chase bank account Bitcoin, they can now. We have New York's making it easier, right, with to use cryptocurrencies, because New York is the worst state for any kind of business to do crypto. And now even Coinbase was like, you can accept it in 150 countries and most states, all 49 states except one, New York. So obviously they have to do something, right? Hyperinflation, will America dodge the bullet? Like, does economic law does not apply to United States? Does Americans have the ability to defy gravity? No, they don't, right? They're going to be subjected. If they print money, they're going to be subjected, and they are printing money. They're going to be subjected to everything that everybody else is subjected to. And yeah, so I really think that it makes sense to own Bitcoins, yet people aren't, yet the price does not tells you, like, I mean, everything, the TA is telling you that this is not good. This is not good at all. We're gonna roll over and probably come all the way down to the 7,000 range, in the 7,000 range, which is like ridiculous, right? When you compare it to the fundamentals. But that's just the way it is. Anyhow, so if you enjoy this TA and want to learn more and want to know what we're planning on doing, you can subscribe to Pandora's Wallet. Just head over to www.pandoraswallet.com. Right, we have a lot of happy customers in that have subscribed to Pandora's Wallet and are part of the Telegram group. So you can be a part of that group as well. Just try it out. You can try it out for just 1 month and see how it goes. Right. And yeah, we'll read off here. Let me read off some of the testimonials from here. Phyllison says, Da Vinci's Hail Mary trade on May 3rd, 2020. This Hail Mary trade is paying for my Pandora's Wallet subscription by itself. And L is saying, the group is nice. Da Vinci is a good-hearted guy. He gives me much knowledge about technical things, and I think the prices are too cheap. Well, thank you, L. Yeah, so if you want to be a part of the group, right, just head over to www.pandoraswallet.com and purchase your subscription today. Now, let's head over to some questions that some people have asked. And Nathan asks, Right now, it's hard to DCA without using your bank and centralized exchange. Do you have recommendations on a better way to DCA without being so dependent on private institutions? Well, yes, I do, Nathan. I have one of the ways that you can do that, and that nobody really thinks of, is just, ask for things to be paid in Bitcoin. So if you want to sell something, you want to sell your services, you want to sell something in your house, ask to be paid in Bitcoin. Another way is I have a good friend that I know it's kind of hard for those people to do it because of the government and the laws. But you can find somebody that will trade with cash with you, right? And you could find, I'm sure you have some friends who are interested in Bitcoin, right? Who have some Bitcoin, who might have sell you the Bitcoins for cash. That's one way you can do that. You can find people. You could put out ads saying, "Hey, I'm willing to trade cash for Bitcoin if you have any Bitcoin," right? And do it that way, right? Yeah, it's not that easily done in the States as much as it is in other countries, but yeah, it is possible. And those are some of the ways that you can get rid of your cash and get into to Bitcoin without having to worry about the government knowing about it, basically, is that's what you're really concerned about. And that's a fair concern. Because when the government is very totalitarian, and they want to take your money at all costs, right? And that's the way it is. And you want to avoid that. And I understand. But yeah, you're just going to have to be creative and come up with ways in order to prevent that from happening. All right, next question. All right. Shannon asked, does Da Vinci think that DeFi will be around for the long term? Yeah, I do. I really think that it will be around for the long term. The reason why is because it's a new technology that basically is rules, the rules of finance without rulers enforcing it. Think about that for a second, right? You don't have to. You wonder if you think you look at the SEC and it's there to protect you from criminals, but actually it does the opposite. It protects the criminals from you, right? So that is the problem with our current structure, right? Is that government is a racket for large organized crime. And so with DeFi, now we have a new system. And the cool thing about DeFi, right, is that I wish I had to set up a video to play. But you know what? What is that the billionaires, they don't know about DeFi. They think that DeFi is nothing because it's new. It's too new. It's like 2 years old, right? And it's the next big thing, right? It's the next big thing that they're going to be invested in, and you get a chance to buy in low. So wherever you see a DeFi project, I would suggest that if you were to put like 1% of like take a total amount of money that you're going to throw away, right? That you would be glad you would be okay if it went to zero. And then you went and find like 100 different DeFi projects, and I doubt there is 100 different DeFi projects, but let's just say you could find one. And you split them up to that 1% of that total money that you were willing to go to zero. 1% in each of DeFi projects. Within 5 to 6 years, those DeFi projects will be worth like will give you 100x. Those that more than 100x each one of like about I would say about 10% of them will go to 100x. And so you could say that, you know what, you would gain 10x of your money just by spreading it out across 1% across all the DeFi projects. Unfortunately, there's 100 DeFi projects to do that. But yeah, that's an easy win right there. And some will even do more than 100x. Some might even do 1,000x in the next six years. But I think we'll see some 100x's probably in the next 2 years for sure, at the very least. But this is the next big thing, and I'm looking forward to it, and I'm glad to be in this space because there's so much here, there's so many cool things that's happening, that it's incredible, and we get to be at the ground up. You know, normally whenever there's a financial revolution in the space, right? It usually happens at the top. Down, coming down. With crypto, it's from the bottom up, and you can see that when billionaires are like, DeFi, what's that? Oh man, they have no idea what's going on, and I'm so glad, because this is so much better, because now what's happening is that with DeFi is that you have to prove it out with the little guy, because the little guy, right? He has like small enough money to go and try this out. Let me try that and see. And he has the most to gain from trying this out, because he can't gain access to those complex financial products that DeFi is providing. So for example, let me give you an example, right? DeFi all provides you with loans of any amount, right? That you can use in a transaction. In one transaction. Now imagine that, be able to do that in the current financial system, what you can do, right? That does not exist for you. It exists for other people, the super rich, but not for you. But now with DeFi, it does exist for you, that you could actually borrow money, any amounts of money, large or small, and long as you pay it back in one transaction, you'll be able to do it. Amazing. Amazing. And these are the kind of things. This is just one of the many, many, many different projects that are out there that make complex financial transactions possible and available to the average little guy. It's unbelievable. So, I think DeFi is here to stay. Invest in wherever you can. And because it will, most of those projects will be doing well in the future. Not all of them, of course, I would say about 90% will go to zero, but there's going to be some huge winners in the space, and look out for that. So thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I hope to see you guys next time. All right, cheers, peace.